Hello everyone, welcome back to the second video. Now in this video I'm going to demonstrate how you set up the second part of the apparatus for the gas stoichiometry lab. So for this one you'll need your container, your large container. Now this container is filled about, you can see it filled up to this far. That might be a little too much. You might want to go down less, so maybe about down to here for the purposes of the lab, since this might overflow. You don't want it to overflow, and you might have to stick your hand in the water, but we'll see how it goes at that level. You'll also need your graduated cylinder, and I'll move my laptop so you can see that better. So you'll see that the graduated cylinder already has water in it. I have filled it up all the way to the top. You can see the water coming above the rim. So the reason for that is because you want as little air in this graduated cylinder as possible, because the whole point is you're going to be collecting air through this tube, and you want it into the graduated cylinder. So you're going to collect air in the graduated cylinder. So if you already have air in there, it's going to mess up your results. So there's a couple of ways you can do this. One way you can do this is you can put your hand tightly, the palm of your hand tightly on top, and squeeze down. And then that'll create I forget the word I'm looking for. So it's going to create a seal, and that's going to keep the water from coming out. So you got to make sure it's tight on there. And then what you're going to do is you're going to turn it over with your hand, and then you want to stick your hand in the water without letting loose off of the graduated cylinder. Otherwise you're going to lose the water, air is going to get in, and then you're going to have to do it over. So that's one way to do it. It's a little difficult to do it that way, but you can be successful. And you can get maybe a minimal amount of air in your graduated cylinder. Another way you could try to do it is with Reynolds Wrap or plastic wrap. So instead of using your hand, what you can do is use the plastic wrap and put that over there. Don't pull too tight and break the plastic wrap, but create a seal with the plastic wrap. So that's what I'm going to try here. So I'm going to try that. So you've got that done. And so what you can then now do is easily turn it over and submerge it into the water. And then while it's in the water, just take the plastic wrap off, and you should not lose any of the water inside. So I'm going to turn it over, stick it inside. Now I can take off the Reynolds wrap. Okay, let me tilt this down. So when you're taking off the Reynolds wrap, just make sure you don't lift up the end of the graduated cylinder out of the water. Otherwise, the air from the atmosphere will go in and you'll lose your water. Okay, so there we go. So now you'll notice that very little water. Now I can let it sit on the side there. As long as it's submerged, nothing should go wrong. And you'll notice I have a towel on the table, so that's in case if I spill or if it doesn't go as planned, I don't make a mess all over the table. All right, so that's how you do part two, and you'll see that I can lift it up, but just don't lift it above the surface. So the third part is going to be taking this end of the tube and putting it into the graduated cylinder. So remember, we've attached this end to our Erlenmeyer flask, and then now we need to get this end into the graduated cylinder. So we need to get it in there without losing our water. Okay, so that'll be the next video. Join me next time.